Hiya, welcome to my channel, Stories with Nat. Please like and subscribe for more videos. Today's story is...
Lettuce, the Fairy Ball. Lettuce Rabbit and her family lived high up on top of a hill. Nibble, nibble, hop, hop, every day was the same. Until one summer afternoon. Lettuce was making daisy chains when she felt a sharp tug. The daisy chain stretched and ping! It broke and whisked away. Two tiny figures with shimmering wings were pulling it through the air. Stop! Shrieked Lettuce. All of a sudden, they swooped down a hole in the root of an old oak. Lettuce pressed her nose inside, but she was too big to go through. Who are you? She cried. What are you doing? Lettuce jumped back. Suddenly, in front of her was a group of tiny people. Rabbit? Laughed one. Our queen needs your daisy chain for the fairy ball in Fairyland. Fairyland? Squeaked Lettuce. I'd like to go to Fairyland. But I'm too big. If you give us your chain, we will sprinkle fairy dust on you, giggled a chorus of little voices, and the air filled with golden sparkles.
Tissue,
sneezed Lettuce. Suddenly, she was shrinking and shrinking. And then she was no bigger than an oak leaf. Happily, Lettuce dashed into the hole after the fairies. Inside, it was dark. But soon she came to a door, and through it was
Fairyland.
Quick now, said the fairies. It's time to put on our best clothes to welcome the queen. Lettuce's face fell. What was she going to wear? Don't worry, laughed the fairies. Just close your eyes. Lettuce stood still. She could feel something soft and light, smelling of flowers dropping over her ears. It was the prettiest little fairy dress trimmed with thistledown. Just then, a bossy elf cried, "Make way for Her Majesty, Queen Titania." The fairy queen had arrived. She was riding in a carriage made of yellow rose petals, drawn by a yellow bird, and her reins were Lettuce's daisy chain.
Welcome, little rabbit. Thank you for my beautiful reins, smiled the queen, holding out a tiny bracelet. This is for you. It will grant you one wish. Use it well. Then young elves brought out the most wonderful fairy feast. Afterwards, everyone danced, especially Lettuce. All too soon, it was time to go.
We won't forget you, Lettuce, called the fairies, waving goodbye.
Wait, squeaked Lettuce. I'm still small.
Just then, a cloud of fairy dust floated down, making Lettuce's nose twitch. The ground felt all wobbly, and she was growing bigger and bigger and bigger until she was the right size. In two hops and a jump, Lettuce was home. She bounced in to tell her family all about the fairies.
They're ever so small and pretty, she sighed. Oh, I wish you could see them too.
Just then, the magic bracelet on her paw glowed, and Lettuce was sure she heard fairy laughter.
Lettuce's brothers and sisters couldn't believe their eyes. Fluttering above them were hundreds of smiling fairies. As she gazed up, Lettuce murmured happily, "My wish came true. I'm such a lucky rabbit."
Don't forget to tap that like button, like and subscribe. Thanks, guys.